throughout Perth in the world, family. And we don't need to give them our attention. We literally are giving them life. I want to give life to people who are in alignment with what I'm giving life to. It's not rocket science. It's very simple. It's not hard. It's not even, oh my God, I need to. It's very simple. What? This is what I'm on. Who else is on it? Oh, you're on it too. Well, I like that. You get what I'm saying? And Vicky, along with many other people who are even on this live right now, are some of those people, man. So yeah, jump on her page right now and meet me back here 10 a.m. for Cesaroja. Channeling! Yeah, channeling! Get that program! Sorry, family. I'm gassed. Peace in.
Love out.
Also, lastly, you can listen to this. This is part of a podcast. Go type Spiritual Health with Mikkel on Google or on Spotify, on Apple, on Anchor, and you'll be able to listen back to this podcast, family. I want you to listen back. It's going to be on my IGTV, but it will also be available as a podcast for you to listen to. So go back, type Spiritual Health with Mikkel on all of these platforms, and you'll be able to listen to the podcast we've been doing for nearly 2 years, family. Tell me, message me, tweet me, at Mikkel Amin. I always want to know what messages you're leaving with, what is being exposed, what have you taken away from these sessions. Message me, tag me, in all of that. Also, if anyone would like one-to-one spiritual health coaching, family,
definitely at me do that.
For one-to-one spiritual health coaching, this is the work that I do one-to-one with people. If anyone would like one-to-one, holler at your brother from another motherland. Also, if you want to start to connect with the community that surrounds Warojo House, that's this Warojo House, family. Yes, the lifestyle of world changers. Come and study with us every Sunday. We study the laws of Ma'at, the ancient principles.
Yeah, where's my book? Where's my book?
We study that, and I do a
breakdown
every Sunday.
Where's my book?
You can book yourself onto that via my website.
Also, I've been tidying up,
free,
and I don't know where my stuff is. Where's my stuff? Oh, I moved it.
Next time, peace in,
love out.
Inside.
All right. Let's go. Yeah. Ghana. I'm so cool, I went to Africa. Back at school, they were laughing. Now it's cool to be black as fuck. Now it's cool to be from Africa, huh? Went to Ghana, now I'm acting up. Went to Ghana, now I'm acting up. It's so cool to be from Africa. It's so cool to be from Africa, huh? I'm so cool, I went to Africa. Back at school, they were laughing. Tell the truth, it was cruel. Now it's too cool to be black as fuck. Now it's cool to be from Africa. Now it's cool to be from Africa, huh? Went to Ghana. Good morning, Grand Rising. Warrior Queens. Let's fucking go. Bit early to swear, isn't it? 6 years ago today, Chadwick Boseman was introduced to the world as the Black Panther. Thank you very much. We're so grateful. Thank you. I've been feeling my fro, and I'm thinking, you know, all those old, I don't know if anyone else watches kung fu movies. But you know, the old school kung fu movies, like the one that Wu-Tang used to listen to, watch, where they got their inspiration from, where RZA gets his inspiration from. Have anyone seen The Five Venoms? Anybody? Anybody seen The Five Venoms? And those kung fu movies where there's the guy, the black guy, and he's got the hugest afro, and he's just the bomb. Yeah, I'm just trying to channel that right now. And we have our own female warriors as well. You know this? That's what I'm just trying to channel. So I'm channeling women warriors. That's right. Anyway, we've got a foam roll first anyway. Anyway, and I'm scared to put this song back on because I don't want them to block it. I don't want them to block my video. Put a mouth guard in. Nah, because then I won't be able to speak. Right then, so very important. Yes, thank you, sis. Kung fu movie. Oh, look, dog, you can't come in. No, sorry. Bless him. He just wants to be involved. Oh. pre-roll. I roll while I'm watching Mikhail's spiritual health talk. But I didn't do that today. I've been doing some other stuff. So, a good friend of mine, amazing vegan Nigerian cook, celebrity, personality extraordinaire. She's got a new cookbook coming out. And she's asked me to write an introduction. I'm so honoured. I'm literally so honoured. So I'm thinking about that. She needs it back soon, so I've been doing that. So I haven't phone rolled today. I'm not gonna cry. Oh, Jesus Christ. So yeah, come on. We're gonna do, what's happening today? We've got, oh my God, there's this punch I wanna show you. Superman punch. Ah! So we're gonna call it a Superwoman punch, obviously. Because we're completely sexist here. Completely. Suck it. Men get everything and they can suck it. They can really suck it. Oh my God, I've got new shorts on. Whee! I will, when I post this video, I will tag the people that made shorts. Get down. Use words. And it was actually a brother in our community that put me onto it. Gachu said, oh, have you seen this company? Because I know some of your sisters are looking for workout clothes. And I did have a look, and they're amazing. Oh, thank you. Can I do this whole workout with an afro combing? Maybe I can. Right then. Paying attention to all the muscles that have been working hard this week. Women warriors, that's my brothers. So, we're also going to be doing some knees. We won't be able to do a flying knee if you feel like it. If you feel like, if you've got the space and you're not going to like total your TV, yeah? Yeah, we could do a Superman punch. Do some flying knees. We're gonna work with levels, as in a couple punches there, crouch down a couple punches. So we're still getting our glute and low body work in. Again, all this stuff, I'm getting my inspiration from the MMA program on this online portal that I use. With the super little ginger lady. She's like a little firecracker. I love her so much. She's amazing. I bet she's still taller than me though. You lot think I'm tall. I'm not tall. At all. I'm a freaking African hobbit. I'm a pygmy tribe of the steppes of Nigeria. Alright. Usually having a t-shirt on is not amazing for phone money because it can get caught. See what? You got to. And I know definitely my upper body. Oh! My shoulders. Oh, I'm seeing my shoulder blades. Because of all those punches we've been throwing. Oh! And, you know, I've been saying I'm trying to repair my shoulder. I think I might have some nerve damage there. Which is interesting. Oh, is it rolling off camera? Yeah, I might have some nerve damage in my shoulder actually. Which is interesting and a bit annoying. However, now that I think I've narrowed down what it is, I can begin to focus on it properly and repair it. I think it's my axillary nerve. How annoying. So if anyone's got any info about repairing axillary nerve damage, let me know. I've seen some physio exercises that I can do already. But anything extra, just let me know. Oh, God. It's not going to stop me training, because as soon as you stop training, you're not strengthening, and everything just gets weaker and more damaged. I will rest it and use it carefully, but I'm not going to stop training. I'm not going to overtrain, because I'm not daft. And I say that because of experience. I've definitely overtrained in the past. So guys, I know this foam rolling can take a little while, but it's because it's really, really important. I can't imagine a stretch being able to do what the foam roller can do. It's just not possible. Or unless you live with a physio, then yeah, there you go. Then that's fine. But otherwise, you've got to do the work to get the results. You've got to do the repair as well. Also, I'm thinking I'm going to go and have, I'm going to do myself an actual repair session, and I might do it on the weekend. So, if I do Warrior Week all week, might do my side leg. If I do Warrior Week all week, support yourself with the leg in front of you and your arms, and just roll that side bit there, because it doesn't really get much attention. Yeah, worry week all week, and then a repair session on the weekend, Saturday probably, because get it, hang on, because Saturday is our day off, really, in the community. And I didn't get to meet any of the love services last night at all. Oh, except, one of the sisters did a half a yoga session last night. And I flipping missed that as well. But it's all right, because she posted it straight after. So then I got to do it. So needed. I didn't realise how, because I did feel uneasy. And I don't know if that's to do with the fact that I was missing the love services. And I'm, you know, you get into a routine. Hang on. It's that bit again. I feel it popping sideways as I roll over it. Got it. Whoa. Right then. Yeah, so I did her yoga session last night at about, I don't know what time was it, 9:30 or something. Fell asleep during the meditation. I did the meditation, then I had a beautiful sleep. I was sitting up. Oh, that's beautiful. And there was a point where we were laying down, we were in Savasana, and she was like, okay, so relax your shoulders. And I was like, oh yeah, I need to relax my shoulders. And she said, relax your face and unclench your jaw. And until that moment, I hadn't realized that my jaw was clenched and my face was all, eh. And then, relax your hands. And then, until then, I didn't realize my hands were in a fist. Interesante. So no matter how much you think you're paying attention, you might not be really. I'm going to get a quick drink, and then we're going to get into it. You need to warm up, yeah? It's freezing, am I right? Jeez. Right. Ooh, mad. What I wanted to find, ideally, was some soundtracks from those 70s kung fu movies. I couldn't find anything that was useful enough without all the lads talking on it. But so if anyone knows any soundtracks I can use, send it to me, please. Right then, warming up. I'm going to be doing this. Literally, warming up involves whatever you feel you need and what your body is able to do. I know I have to do these, so I'm doing these. Can you hear it? Amazing. imagine him, you know, the big drum things, and they're on the walls, and they've got the massive sticks and the drums, huge. How cool. Okay, back to my upper body. I've never listened to it in its entirety before, so this is also... going to be a video of me being tickled by some cool soundtrack music. Kick your own ass! Right then, almost ready? I am. Smooth movement. So I'm not trying to get my live locked off, but at least we can honour some snippets of the music that have made our life so rich. actually so happy that nowadays music is changing, because you know, you listen to the songs that you used to listen to and it's all business and homes and stuff and bling and look at my diamonds and my car. I just can't listen to it anymore. I'm like, yo, if it's an instrumental version, I'll play that one, but I cannot listen to you saying that rubbish. I don't care what your name is. I don't care if you're Tupac, Shupac, 3 9s, 4 boots. Nah. Anyway. Right then. What are we starting with? What are we starting with, little ginger lady? Just put some of my music on so I won't get into trouble. Okay, I'm just doing a roundhouse kick. So, normal stance that we're usually in. Step, bring it up, slap it. So, what we're doing is hit the target with this part of our foot. Reset. Step up, bring your front leg up, snap it out. Put it down, step back. That's all we're doing. And again, height doesn't matter, but it's different to obviously a front kick where you are lifting it straight up and doing this. This one, you are rotating and your hip has to get into that movement. Those new movements we've been practicing, it has to get up here because it's kicking to the side. All right. Whatever tempo you need. Keeping your guard up. Protect your beautiful face. Exhale. 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 Keep going. This is nice and easy to begin with, am I right? I'm gonna keep down there. You could use it as, instead of kicking someone on the side, you could use it as a way to take their knee away so they're off balance. Okay, that'll do. Now we're going to get into these different level punches. One, two, crouch. One, two, pivoting. On the arm that's doing the punching. Just over here. mum punch now. Okay, what we doing? The way to do a Superman punch, hold up. Bring this hand. I'm gonna punch with the back arm and the back leg is gonna come in, kick out and propel us forward. Do it on the spot. literally grabbing it. I'm not sure what the next cardio spike is going to be, so I'm quite excited to see what they're going to do. Something else. Ooh, what are we doing? I think we're just switching sides. Go on then. Switching sides. I'm not using it as an excuse to have a rest, because what are we doing? We switch sides. Same, punch, punch, knee, knee. I forgot. These are my coordination for the morning. Do not think. Oh, sweet, I forgot. Start again. One, two, while I'm here. Knee, then step, and knee. Okay, come on, concentrate. I feel like Eddie Gordo right now. What's that other lady called in Tekken? Can't remember. The one that's supposed to be his, like, female equivalent, but isn't really, because she's a bit crap. Lean into the knee, but not too much. You don't want to hurt yourself. Oh, shit, the bed. You're doing this thing, yeah? You're going into a lunge. I notoriously hate lunges, but you're not narrow, you're wide. Ah! Vegan lifestyle, what can I say? Plant-based, ethical, organic, vegan. No nutritional deficiencies here. Lunge. Drop your knee down. I think I need to do it this way. Pulse. The lunge. And then you're gonna jump to the other side of your mat. You're gonna do the same thing, pulse the lunge. With a lunge, be careful not to lean forward. Your knee's gotta be over your ankle. And really, leaning back really, to make this as straight as possible. None of that, all of this. So get me. Right then, I will demonstrate. just like sugar, right? 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. It's a capoeira move. What's it called? This is the jinga, actually. I was wrong the other week. This is a jinga. Ooh. Keeping close attention to the alignment of your spine, your hips, your knees. This is where I encourage everybody. I don't care if you don't go on Instagram, or you don't go live, or you don't do any of that crap. I don't care. Have a mirror. If you haven't got a mirror, that's why you need your phone. That's one guy. Day. Have your phone. Point it at you. Look at yourself. Are you in alignment, or are you doing that? Because if you do that, you'll hurt yourself. I know, because that's what I did. And then I was like, oops. You learn from your mistakes. But then that's a bit shit and annoying. Do you know what I mean? Right, back to this. Punch, punch, knee, knee. It does look painful, but the pain is not an injurious type of pain. You've not injured yourself, you're just making your muscles work, you're putting them under stress in order to make them get bigger, more efficient, stronger, leaner, whichever one you want really out of your muscles. So the strength, that's what we're looking for. Because I am aiming for 120 years old. My afro is going to be beautifully silver. Can't wait. Jinga. Wait, I think my arm's this way. Cross your opponent's face like this, and your thumb is tracking close to your face. That's all it is. And again, whichever arm is throwing the move, pivot on the same leg to make the movement smooth and natural. And don't hurt yourself. Don't hurt yourself. Now, again, you're using your core. You're engaging those abs to help swing the elbow around. That's why I like to exhale when we do that. And when you do that, you pay attention, you feel your abs going, ow, ow. Spike. High knees. Oh, we've only got a little bit left. So what we're going to do is, to make sure we're being functional as well as warriors, yeah, I'm going to do the last elbows on the opposite side. Last cardio spike, foam roll stretch. You got it. Come on. You're in bed. I love you, vegan fam. I love you so much. But you know what? You can just catch the replay. It's fine. Thanks for tuning in. Thank you. I hope your bed is so comfortable that it gives you all the comfort that you need this morning. Remembering all the elements. So engaging the core to twist your body around, lifting the elbow, dragging your thumb across your face, pivoting. They're not motivated to learn. I'm not saying I'm a child, but it's the same thing. If that child is not motivated to learn the thing, you'll just be torturing them to make them keep it in their head. And it will never be information to them, it'll just be data. So anyway, my energy comes from the motivation to enjoy the out of my life. That's all it is, right? And I realized, because of a cataclysmic event, health-wise, that
my life is going to be short and shit if I don't do something about the state of my health, spiritually and physically, immediately. So I started to address the physical side because I didn't really know anything about the spiritual side. But the physical side was, there's information about it everywhere and it's quite straightforward, really. So I healed myself, did my own research, healed my body, and I was like, oh shit, okay. So literally this needs to be applied to my whole family so that they don't then end up growing up, getting to a point where they have a cataclysmic health event and then need to be like, oh, how do I save myself? Oh no, I'm gonna die. Because basically I'm just dying quicker than I'm supposed to. And to be fair, everybody is. Because we're supposed to have a really, really long lifespan. But we're not getting it. Because we don't know that that's our natural lifespan. It's like a chicken's natural lifespan is about 6 years, but they get eaten at about 6 weeks old. They're naturally force-fed and super-grown to be big enough for sale to be eaten. And actually, they're a really, really, really intelligent animal, and it pisses me off. But hey, that's for other people to find out for themselves. I realised that being a carcass cruncher is really not it. My husband coined that term. I don't know where he got it from. He might have got it from someone else, but carcass cruncher, because that's basically what it is. So my daughter was having this conversation with someone the other day, and she was saying, oh, she loves to know what people's favourite foods are. So what's your favourite food? And all the favourite foods involve some kind of animal. And I'm just wondering, if all those things didn't exist, because it's basically the same four animals over and over again. And you just put it in different combinations and you have to season the fuck out of it so that it tastes all right. Because if you're supposed to eat pig, dead pig, dead chicken, dead cow, dead fish, you just take it and eat it, wouldn't you? Surely that's we'd have big old teeth and we'd rip it off and be like, yeah, and then we cook the vegetables on the side. But no, we don't do that. And we don't go and kill a pig. We go to a supermarket and get a piece of flesh wrapped in plastic and toxic packaging. We buy a piece of flesh from a dead animal that died in pain and fear, that had been pumped with antibiotics and chemicals all its life, lived an unnatural life, and then is covered in the supermarket in toxic packaging. And this I realized, and this I changed my life, and now I'm not dying as quickly as I was supposed to be, as quickly as I was, and I'm going to live to 120. My husband's a bit, he said, well, I'm going to have to be 125 then. And I was like, yeah, we'll go together, innit, when we're done. Because he's 5 years older than me. Ooh, that went a bit dark. I didn't mean it. Well, yeah, I did. I'm from Yorkshire. I mean what I say, and I say what I mean. We don't, excuse the pun, mince words. Right then, I suggest you put some good tunes on, liven up the mood, because I took it a bit dark. Come on. Actually, yeah, this will go. Get some stretching done, get ready to Chesaroho. I can't flipping wait to Chesaroho! I think I've worked myself into a bit of a activist state. Yeah. That's the other thing I realised. Our guts lining does not like anything to do with wheat. Rice is generally not very cool unless it's organic brown. But you know what? Eliminating the dead flesh, you're doing a lot for the planet. A lot. And now it's just a case of doing more for yourself, darling. That's all. Because if you don't look after yourself, you're the first port of call, babes. Just do better for yourself. If you want any info about anything, let me know, yeah? I'd love to help, if you want help, and if you need help. All right. Where was I up to? Never foam roll your knees over your knees in any way. You can put extra weight by using the other leg to press down. If you need a bit more of a get in there, foam roll action. Yeah. And this part of our leg hardly gets any love, really. It just doesn't get the love, and we should pay attention to that side, because I realised that I was getting knee problems because this side was getting too tight and it's pulling my knee out of where it's supposed to be. So yeah, the more you learn, it's fascinating being alive. Like Mikhail said, it is a flipping psychedelic experience. It's great. I love it so much. Right then, I'm going to end in a minute because we've got to chase a runner. I wonder what he's got in store for us today. I'm going to end while I do a bit of stretching. But I'm going to go through this first, yeah. I might do a back bend today. Oh, yeah. Always getting a squat in. Always getting a squat in. How is your squat looking nowadays? We've been on this tip for a little while. I really hope that everyone practices their squats because... Oh, man. Have you got stuff to do in your life? Yeah. Loads to do, loads to do, loads to see. And you want to walk there. Thanks for tuning in to Women's Warrior Week. Ta-ta-la. I'll see you tomorrow.